Hey Cherubs, come back with me to 1993 for a bit. I've been playing Doom for hours, and I finally made it to the last level of the episode. I defeat the bosses, and the walls around the room collapse. The once dark and claustrophobic level opens up, and the tension that's been culminating over this long and arduous journey is finally relieved. I flip a switch, and a staircase dramatically ascends and symbolizes my triumph. Before I leave, I take a brief look back, reminisce on all the struggles that I've overcome, and step forward to embrace my victory. Wait, what? The teleporter sends me into a trap that's pitch black and full of enemies. The text that appears on screen after captures my sentiments pretty well. You're supposed to win, aren't you? Where's your fat reward and ticket home? It's not supposed to end this way. There's actually a simple explanation as to why this level is designed in this way. Doom was a shareware game, so the first episode was designed as a demo. If you can't end on a disappointing note, then hey, why not pay 40 bucks for the rest of the game? That's good marketing. But that wasn't good enough for young Matthew. Nothing about this ending was acceptable. And if you know anything about me, you know that I'm the obsessive type. And I had all the time in the world. I was determined to get my true ending. You can't beat me! I know all the cheat codes! Okay, so first I'm gonna turn on invulnerability. Then I better unlock all the weapons. And then I'm gonna turn the lights on, because why not? Okay, so the first problem is that the trap is programmed to disable the invulnerability cheat, so I still die. This blew my mind as a kid. It was tantamount to God being pulled out of heaven. So then I enabled the other invulnerability cheat that turns the screen white and black, and hey, now we're cooking with gas! I beat all the monsters, but nothing happens. And I'm stuck. I can't move. So I enable the cheat that allows me to walk through walls, and now I can move around. But there's nothing to do here. It's just an empty room, with no exit. I can escape back to the rest of the level by cheating, but now what? Where do I go? Every level before this has a special room with an exit switch inside. And this level doesn't have one. Years later, when I had some Doom level editing software, I loaded this map and discovered that it actually does have an exit. But the bona fide exit is your health falling below 10% in the trap. Yeah, the trap is the real exit. That's it. Throughout my life, I've been told that perseverance builds character. Life is tough, but overcoming hardships through struggles makes us strong and compelling. But what do you do when you're faced with an impossible situation? Number one, you can try to extricate yourself from the situation. There's no need to continue getting hurt just for the sake of getting hurt. There are better games out there. Number two, you can come to terms with the situation. We all face battles that we can't win and things that are beyond our control. We do, however, have the ability to control our attitudes toward these situations. Life isn't fair, but that doesn't mean that it can't be good and that we shouldn't try to make the most of it. Number three, you can redefine the situation. The first thing that I did with the level editor was remap this secret switch as an exit switch. On a more pragmatic note, the reason why I pursued medicine was because I was unsatisfied with the way my grandfather's life ended, and I wanted to help people avoid similar tragedies. Number four, last and definitely least, you can be a stubborn dinosaur like young Matthew and attempt to swim to the moon. This is a diorama that I made, that's my take on an Asian fable. Bronte the dinosaur is walking on the beach one night, and he sees the moon's reflection out on the water. He attempts to swim to it. Obviously that's ludicrous, and he doesn't even understand that he's swimming toward the moon's reflection, and not the moon itself. But yeah, sometimes that's who I am. A boy who doesn't see the world as it is, or even how it should be. I see the world as I am. So for all of you out there who are still watching, thank you for putting up with me, even if I am a no-win situation.